Why are there duplicate files on my computer? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. Glary Utilities has a section called Remove Duplicates. I tried it and it does get stuck when one chooses Delete All Checked Files. The question is, how come there are duplicate files on the computer? If one is working on a file then saves it, it should go to the original file and not create a new one. An explanation would be very welcome. I need to start by strongly advising against blindly deleting duplicate files. Done incorrectly, you can quickly render your computer unbootable. Duplicate files happen for several reasons, and surprisingly, what you and I do is not at the top of the list. I've talked before about how it's not that uncommon to have multiple copies, often identical copies, of files that are used by the software installed on your machine. This happens legitimately for a variety of reasons, but mostly boils down to programs not wanting to put themselves at risk because of the bad behaviors of other programs. For example, Program A installs a copy of shared code. If Program B also uses this same library of code, then there are two approaches B's installer could take. Program B could notice that there's already a copy of the library, and therefore not install another. Or Program B could install its own duplicate copy. The problem with the first approach is that Program A could be uninstalled or updated and somehow change or remove the shared library. The net result is that Program B could stop working. Many programs now carry and install their own copies of many libraries and support files to remain in control of their own destiny. The result? Legitimate, duplicate files. Windows is another case where it tries to protect you in many ways that involve having duplicate copies of files. For example, system file protection is a technology that monitors the system for unexpected changes, often because of malware. When it detects such changes, it restores the file that's affected from a duplicate backup copy. Now, in older versions of Windows, there was a folder called IE386 that contained a copy of the files on the installation media. And if you have a Windows.old folder, well, that contains the previous operating copy of the operating system. There are many files that don't change from version to version, thus qualifying as duplicates of the files on your current system. Applications do it too. I have multiple versions of some programs installed. Not all files change between the versions. This is often because of things like sample or other support files that simply don't need to change between versions. Some applications update themselves by saving the previous version of the file being updated. That can often show up as a duplicate, depending on the type of duplicate search you've been running. Some applications are organized that their various subcomponents include duplicate files. And the system I use to keep track of all the files that make up my websites, videos, and more maintains a duplicate copy of every file in its control so that it can quickly detect changes locally. The list goes on. There were plenty of duplicates that, on even my machine, I really had no definite answer for, though I had some suspicions. The takeaway here is really simple. Many applications install, manage, or maintain duplicate files for a variety of what turn out to be very legitimate reasons. Bottom line, when it comes to deleting duplicates, don't, please don't, unless you really know what you're doing, just don't. As we've seen, there are many legitimate reasons for duplicate files. Deleting those duplicate files at best will cause an application or two to misbehave, and at worst, could delete a critical file out from underneath Windows itself. If you must delete duplicates, limit yourself to those files you are 100% certain you recognize. For example, if you've been managing photographs or music on your PC and suspect that as part of that you have lots of duplicates, then a duplicate file scan of only those files might be in order. Even then, I think twice about turning over control to the program to perform the deletion. I might use the information that it gives me to guide my own more deliberate manual actions. Now, a lot of people end up looking for duplicate files because they're low on disk space. In my mind, that's the wrong solution to the problem. If you're running low on disk space, then instead focus on what's actually using up the space. More often than not, it will not be duplicate files at all, but something else that is usually much easier and safer to clean up. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/18151. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.